Welcome back to part two of our Azure logging and monitoring session for ISVs. If you did not see part one, Azure Monitor Overview, of this series, I encourage you to go back and take a look. For this part of the series, we will take a closer look at the different insights we can get at each level of our solution. So to recap from the last video, when we look at the types of telemetry we can collect in Azure, they typically fall into three categories: infrastructure, application, or platform level. So for this session, we will look at some of the nuances of each level. Let's begin with platform logs. Platform logs provide detailed diagnostics and auditing information for Azure resources and the Azure platform they depend on. They are automatically generated through Azure. However, if you want to retain them for a period longer than 30 days, you need to configure the platform logs to be forwarded to one or more destinations to be retained. The three types of platform logs are resource logs, activity logs, and Azure Active Directory logs. The first type we will talk about are resource logs. Resource logs operate at the Azure resource level. They provide insight into operations that are performed within an Azure resource. For example, getting a secret from a key vault or making a request to a database. Let's head to the Azure portal to get a better view. The content of resource logs varies by the Azure service and resource type. Each Azure resource requires its own diagnostic setting, which defines the categories of logs and metric data sent to the destination specified in that setting. The available categories will vary for different resource types. So let's take a moment to set up the diagnostic setting for a resource. We will navigate to our resource group with some resources already inside. Now let's set up the diagnostic settings for this virtual network. If you navigate to the left side, you will see the diagnostic settings. Now, before we get started, it's important to note that resource logs are not collected by default. They are automatically generated by supported Azure resources, but they aren't available to be viewed unless you send them to a destination. So this is why we must create the diagnostic setting. Simply click Add Diagnostic Setting to the resource that you wish to work with. You will select the type of logs and metric that you want to send. There are three destinations currently that you can send your resource logs to, which include a log analytics workspace, a storage account, and an event hub. For this demo, we will send it to a log analytics workspace. So I created a log analytics workspace beforehand. If you do not already have a log analytics workspace, take some time to create one before you set up a diagnostic setting. Finally, give your diagnostic setting a name. For this purposes, I will just call it Demo Diagnostic. Then, when you are done, hit save. So now we have the diagnostic setting set up for our resource. As we allow the events to flow in, let's continue with the next type of platform log. The second type of platform log we will talk about is the activity log. The activity log occurs at the subscription level. It provides insight into the operations on each Azure resource in the subscription from the management plane, in addition to updates on service health events. So here we have the activity log for our demo subscription. You can see all kinds of activity happening. You can set the views to be daily or weekly. Use the activity log to determine the what, who, and when for any operations like put, post, or delete taken on the resources in your subscription. Keep in mind there's a single activity log for each Azure subscription. You can view the activity log in the Azure portal or retrieve entries with PowerShell and CLI. Finally, we take a brief look at the third and final type of platform log, which is the Active Directory level log. Azure Active Directory logs occur at the Azure tenant level, So if you take a moment to reflect on the hierarchy of Azure, within each tenant, there are multiple subscriptions. So where the activity log operates at the subscription level, the Active Directory log operates at the tenant level, meaning it shows multiple subscriptions. It contains the history of sign-in activity and audit trail of changes made in the Azure Active Directory for a particular tenant. You can restrict access on who gets to see the logs, which is the case here. Since I am on a company tenant, I do not have access to audit logs to see what everyone else on the subscriptions within the tenant are doing, which makes sense. Now, if I were to go into my own tenant, I can see much more information that wasn't previously available, like the audit logs and sign-in logs. It gives you very detailed information on who accessed your tenant and when from what device. This way, you can see what people within your subscription are doing and who is trying to access your resources. Let's move on to the application layer. For all applications running on Azure, the way to monitor would be through Azure Application Insights. As an ISV, this may be the most important level of monitoring that you would need to look at and understand. Application Insights is an extensible application performance management service for developers and DevOps professionals. ISVs can use it to monitor their live applications. It will automatically detect performance anomalies and include powerful analytics tools to help you diagnose issues and to understand what users actually do with your app. It works for apps on a wide variety of platforms, including .NET, Node.js, Java, and Python. It could be used for apps hosted on-prem, hybrid, or any public cloud. It integrates with your DevOps process and has connection points to a variety of development tools. To use Application Insights, you install a small instrumentation package or SDK in your application or enable Application Insights using the Application Insights agent once supported. So if you take a look at the reference documentation, you will see what the supported platform scenarios are. For .NET and Java, you would use the Application Insights SDK. It is important to note that for Python, you would need to use the OpenCensus SDK to send App Insights into Azure Monitoring. So the instrumentation monitors your app and directs the telemetry data to an Azure Application Insights resource using a unique GUID that we refer to as an instrumentation key. You can instrument not only the web service application, but also the background components and the JavaScript in the web pages themselves. The application and its components can run anywhere. It doesn't have to be hosted in Azure. The impact on your app's performance is small. Tracking calls are non-blocking and are batched and sent in a separate thread. You can monitor request rates, response times, and failure rates. You can find out which pages are most popular at what times of day and where your users are. You can even see which pages perform the best. You can also observe things like dependency rates, response times, and failure rates, so you can find out whether external services are slowing you down. One of the key insights you can derive are custom events, which are metrics that you write yourself in the client or server code to track business events, such as items sold or games won, and so much more. Now that we covered the platform-level monitoring and the app-level monitoring, we could begin to look at the types of monitoring available on the infrastructure level. When we say infrastructure monitoring, we refer to compute resources like VMs, VM skill sets, or Azure Arc virtual machines. Virtual machines and other compute resources require an agent to collect monitoring data required to measure the performance and availability of their guest operating systems and workloads. A common scenario ISVs run into is you may have a specific set of requirements that can't be completely met with a single agent for a particular virtual machine. For example, you may want to use metric alerts, which requires Azure Diagnostics extension, but also want to leverage the functionality of Azure Monitor for VMs, which requires the log analytics agent and the dependency agent. In cases such as this, you can use multiple agents, and this is a common scenario for customers who require functionality from each. Windows events logs are one of the most common data sources for log analytics agents on Windows virtual machines, since many applications write to the Windows event log. You can collect events from standard logs such as system and application, in addition to specifying any custom logs created by applications you need to monitor. On the other hand, syslog is an event logging protocol that is common to Linux. Applications will send messages that may be stored on the local machine or delivered to a syslog collector. When the log analytics agent for Linux is installed, it configures the local syslog daemon to forward messages to the agent. The agent then sends the message to Azure Monitor, where a corresponding record is created. In addition to the VM monitoring, we also have Azure Monitor for Containers as a solution to provide insight for your container workloads. Azure Monitor for Containers supports clusters running the Linux and Windows Server 2019 operating system. The container runtimes it supports are Docker, Mobi, and any CRI-compatible runtimes such as CRIO and Containerd. Azure Monitor for Container gives you performance visibility by collecting memory and processor metrics from controllers, nodes, and containers that are available in Kubernetes through the Metrics API. After you enable monitoring from Kubernetes clusters, metrics and logs are automatically collected for you through a containerized version of the Log Analytics Agent for Linux. Metrics are written to the Metrics Store, and log data is written to the Log Store associated with your Log Analytics workspace. Now, as an ISV, a very common scenario is setting up insights for containers. I will now guide you through what that would look like in Azure. To make sure you are receiving container insights, you have to enable the monitor setting. You can do this in a variety of ways, like the Azure portal, using the Azure CLI, using an ARM template in initial deployment, or using Terraform. So let's do this within the Azure portal. Navigate to the Insights section within the Azure Monitor view. There, you'll see which clusters have monitoring enabled or disabled. Make sure to hit Enable for your cluster. As long as you are writing your cluster logs to standard out, you'll be able to leverage these insights within Azure Monitor. Now you'll be able to see insights for your cluster like node CPU utilization, active pod count, and more. If you navigate to the Nodes tab, you'll be able to see more in-depth metrics. So if a node has failed, you can navigate to it and find out the source of the error. As we continue to talk about infrastructure settings, one new service that is worth looking into is the new Azure Lighthouse. With Azure Lighthouse, service providers can deliver managed services using comprehensive management tooling built into the Azure platform. Customers maintain control over who can access their tenant, what resources they can access, and what actions can be taken. Azure Lighthouse is for both managed service providers and customers. Managed service providers can use Azure Lighthouse to help build and scale a secure managed services practice, while customers benefit from best practice security features. Customers have precise control over the scopes they delegate for management and the permissions that are allowed. They can audit service provider actions and remove access completely if desired. Navigate to the Azure Lighthouse docs to learn more about how you can use this in your solution. Another way to gather infrastructure insights is through the Azure Network Watcher. The Azure Network Watcher provides tools to monitor, diagnose, view metrics, and enable or disable logs for resources in an Azure virtual network. Network Watcher is designed to monitor and repair the network health of products, which includes virtual machines, virtual networks, application gateways, load balancers, and more. It is not intended for and will not work with PaaS monitoring or web analytics. Finally, for infrastructure level monitoring, it is worth mentioning the Network Performance Monitor service. Network Performance Monitor is a cloud-based hybrid network monitoring solution that helps you monitor network performance between various points in your network infrastructure. It also helps you monitor network connectivity to service and application endpoints and monitor the performance of Azure Express Route. Network Performance Monitor detects network issues like traffic blackholing, routing errors, and issues that conventional network monitoring methods aren't able to detect. The solution generates alerts and notifies you when a threshold is breached for a network link. It also ensures timely detection of network performance issues and localizes the source of the problem to a particular network segment or device. This concludes the deeper look at the types of monitoring we can see in Azure. So we have all these insights recorded in Azure, so what are we supposed to do with all of it? For our final part of the series, we will talk about how to visualize, analyze, and set up alerts with all the metrics we've gathered.